Family Life Ministries is a very important ministry in the Adventist Church, in the sense that it captures a very wide scope in terms of handling families and the issues that come up in families. It's a ministry that focuses on addressing spiritual issues that arise within our family.
As my husband here said, belonging to a family is something that every individual has a right to, and I'd say particularly to our family, the Family Life Week of Prayer or the Family Life Ministries has made us stick closer. For example, we've learned so much, and I can confirm and say that I'll be a better wife. And it has taught us that for you to be able to have a better relationship with your family, with your children, with your husband, you first of all have to work out your relationship with God. So this has impacted me that in my spiritual life, I will have to relook again at my spiritual life and see my relationship with God, because once it's right with God, then having a nice family relation with your partner, with your children, and even with the church members usually is very easy once your relationship with God is worked out in the right manner.
The Family Life Ministry has had a personal impact to me as an individual, as a Christian, and as a husband.
Mm-hmm.
Because as you know, it has pushed me to read a lot about family issues. It has also exposed me to issues that people go through. So in the course of solving people's issues, you realize that you are also learning some techniques on how to solve your own issues. So, you know, it has opened my eyes to realize the position God is supposed to have in our family. You know, it is important to put God first. It is important to give Him preeminence, because when God takes His proper position in our family, then
everything
else falls into place. So that is what I have learned by being part of this ministry. It has also taught me to be sensitive and kind, because I've realized that you could be looking at a certain couple or a certain family who are behaving in a certain way, and you can be so quick to judge them, you know, harshly. Families have different dynamics. They have different dynamics in families, and families are unique, you know, that each family has its own way of doing things. And so there's no standard, there's no model that it is you as an individual who can decide what you want, you know, to achieve in your family. So words of encouragement. Let me first of all speak to couples. My wife and I met over 10 years ago, and we've been married for 8 years. And marriage is not a bed of roses, but love is a decision. Couples should not base their love on feelings, because feelings change. And especially when realities of life hit in marriage, feelings tend to change. But if you made a decision to love each other, then you will be able to stand anything that will come your way, regardless of the feelings of the moment. So married couples, number one, stick together. Initially, when you are dating, you are thinking for one. You are focusing on your life, your own life as an individual. Remember that when you come into marriage, it is no longer about one person, but about both the two of you. So whatever you do, whichever goals you have in life, please make sure that you work on them as a unit, as a couple, okay? And number two, like I mentioned early, families are different. As a couple, you realize that you are unique in your own way. You are different, you know? So in the sense that you should not try to copy or to want to be like that other couple. Okay? So just try to conduct a self-awareness of your own family. Try to find out your uniqueness and live your life. Okay? Don't compare yourselves with others. Don't give each other pressure because of wanting to compete, to be like another person. Avoid the spirit of competition and just try to make life the way you want it. And number three, I want to remind married couples, your marriage is complete with or without children. I have come across many couples, many young couples who are facing very tough times in their life just because they cannot conceive. Just to tell you that the two of you, the moment you made that decision to love one another, your life is complete, your marriage is complete, just as you are. Of course, it's not easy because the society has expectations, the expectations from families and friends, but just trust in God and know that you are complete the way you are, okay? Yeah, so I think that is what I can tell married couples. Now, my advice to young people who are contemplating marriage. The first thing for you to realize is that I know as a young person you have set out your points in terms of the requirements you want from someone else. The question I'll pose to you is this: have you tried to become the couple that another person will desire to have? Are you desiring in your life to embrace those nice virtues that another person will admire? If you have not done that, I think it is a high time you focused on yourself and not the other person, and make sure that you embrace all those virtues that you have listed that you'll want to see in the other person. And again, you may be struggling for many years looking for a partner, and you think God has left you, God has forsaken you, and then you consider giving up. I want to tell you, one of our hobbies as a family is gardening. We love gardening, you know, in the sense that we sometimes plant crops for fun, and we love it. It fascinates us watching plants grow. And so there's this plant I read about. We have not planted it. It's called a Chinese bamboo. A Chinese bamboo tree, when it's planted, it takes between 4 to 5 years for it to germinate. So what the farmer does is that he plants it, he waters it, and at the same time he fertilizes it for 4 years. 4 to 5 years. I mean, if you were to be a farmer, what is it? Does it make sense to plant something and wait for four or five years for it to germinate? Yet the bamboo tree, after 4 years, it comes out strong. And experts say that it takes within 24 hours, the bamboo tree grows at 3 feet, 3 feet tall at 24 hours. And it takes only up to 6 months for it to grow as a very tall tree, which is 90 feet in height, within 6 months. So can you ask yourself, what has the bamboo tree been doing for the last 5 years?
Yes.
It has been preparing itself by casting roots down deep and wide. So by the time it was sure that it is properly grounded, that's when it comes out of the ground. That's when it sprouts out. And so it is with your life as a young person. Do not worry of the fact that some things are not happening in your life the way you want. God is working in your life and He's doing great things. So just do your part and trust God. He will be able to to allow you to become that which you desire. And this principle applies in all aspects of life, even in your profession, even in your career and in your relationship. Allow God to work through you. you can only do, you only have a small part to do. I mean, you cannot, as a gardener, I don't dictate how my plants should grow. I only plant them and water them and fertilize, and God does the rest. So position yourself as a young person, position yourself as a youth. Ensure that you put the right things into your life, and then God will do his other part if you trust him.
First of all, I'd like to say marriage really works. We're in a situation, we're in an era whereby people are really reflecting negatively on marriage, saying it's a scam, it's a trial and error. But I'm here to confirm that marriage really works, provided the two of you put your efforts into making it really work. And as we said from the beginning, let God be the center of your marriage. And once the center has held up together, then everything else will fall in place. Because God has given us a very good gift of family, let us strive to make it a haven of joy here while we are here on earth, as we wait for the greater joy when we go to heaven. Thank you.